Hello students, in today's lecture we will discuss the bonding behavior of metal carbine complexes. These are the complexes in which there is presence of metal carbon triple bond. Some basic introduction about the metal carbine complexes. Transition metal carbine complexes are organometallic compounds as they contain direct metal carbon bond. And in this case, metal is triply bonded to carbon atom like this. We have a triple bond between metal and carbon atom. This triple bond consists of a sigma bond and two pi bonds. We know that in case of a triple bond, we have one sigma bond and two pi bonds. The bonding behavior involves the interaction of highest occupied molecular orbitals of carbine ligands, which interacts with lowest unoccupied molecular orbitals of the metal to create sigma bond. This part we will discuss in detail in the next portion. The two pi bonds are formed when the two highest occupied molecular orbitals of the metal, they form back bonding with the lowest unoccupied molecular orbitals of carbines. These complexes are also known as metal alkylidienes since the carbon is a carbine ligand. Such compounds are useful in organic synthesis of various types of alkynes as well as nitriles. These complexes are also the focus of much fundamental research, means most of the research is being concentrated on the use of these metal carbon complexes to synthesize various types of organic compounds. So in case of metal carbon complexes, this is the example of metal carbon complexes in which we have chromium as transition metal and this is the metal carbon triple bond, and this bond is very short as compared to the normal chromium carbon single bond. Metal carbon triple bond is shorter than the corresponding metal carbon single bond in case of metal carbonyls. This is justifying the formation of this point is justifying the formation of metal carbon triple bond. In addition to this carbine ligand, we have 4 CO means carbonyl substituents or ligands and 1 iodide. And as told you earlier, the chromium carbon bond, which is coming from carbonyls, is much longer than chromium carbon triple bond of carbine. So this is justifying the formation of some stronger bonds between metal and carbine carbon. It is a combination of a sigma donor bonding from a carbon atom to vacant d orbitals. Bonding is somewhat similar to that of metal carbonyl complexes. We know that in case of metal carbonyls, there is a transfer or a sharing of electrons between lone pair of electrons from carbonyl carbon atom and vacant d orbitals of metal. In the similar way, in this case also, sigma bond is formed by the overlap of filled orbitals of carbine carbon with vacant d orbitals of metal, whereas the two pi acceptor bonds are formed through back bonding interactions. Now what are carbines? We know that atomic number of carbon is 6, and as far as its valential configuration, electronic configuration is concerned, it is 2s2 2p2. In terms of orbitals, it can be shown like this. So we have 2s subshell and 2p subshell. In 2s subshell we have 2 electrons and 2p subshell we have also 2 electrons, because in case of carbines we have bonding like this. Carbines consist of one sigma bond, so let this is the unpaired electron which is forming sigma bond with a substituent R. After this we have now a lone pair of electron, and this is that lone pair of electron which can be donated to vacant d orbitals of metal. So this will result in the formation of metal carbon sigma bond. Any orbital on metal containing unpaired electron will coordinate with this bond, this unpaired electron, to form वन पाई बॉन्ड एंड फेल्ड डी ऑर्बिटल ऑफ मेटल कैन फॉर्म बॉन्ड विद वेकेंट ऑर्बिटल ऑफ कार्बाइन कार्बन एटम टू फॉर्म सेकेंड पाई बॉन्ड. सो इन दिस केस इफ वी कंसिडर वी हैव टू पाई बॉन्ड्स एंड टू सिग्मा बॉन्ड्स एंड द हाइब्रिडाइजेशन वी नो दैट इन हाइब्रिडाइजेशन ओनली सिग्मा बॉन्ड्स आर इन्वॉल्व्ड सो हाइब्रिडाइजेशन विल बी एस पी. एज फार एज द ऑर्बिटल पिक्चर इज कंसर्न्ड दिस कैन बी शोन इन दिस वे फॉर कार्बाइन्स. नाउ सच टाइप ऑफ कार्बाइन इज नोन एज डबलेट कार्बाइन. हाउ इट कैन बी शोन दैट इट इज अ डबलेट कार्बाइन लेट मी ड्रॉ इट अगेन. वी हैव 2s sub shell, we have 2p sub shell for carbon. In 2p sub shell, we have 3 orbitals. In 2s sub shell, we have a pair of electrons, whereas 2p sub shell has 2 unpaired electrons. This is the carbon atom. So, what is happening? As I told you earlier, one of the bond is formed with a substituent like R, as this is the case. Okay, so this is that substituent which is sigma bonded to this carbon atom. Now after this we have only one unpaired electron left and one lone pair of electron and one vacant p orbital. So you can see here this is the orbital which is containing lone pair of electrons, means this one. This is the sigma bond formed with alkyl substituent. We have shown this. And this p orbital contains unpaired electron and one p orbital is lying vacant. Hybridization of the carbon atom is sp. Now since only one unpaired electron is present, means its total spin is half. So multiplicity 2s plus 1 will be equal to 2. That's why it is called doublet carbine. Another type of carbine which can be mentioned here is quartet carbine. In that case, we have excited state configuration for carbon. Means one of the electrons from 2s subshell has been transferred to vacant 2p orbital as shown in this diagram here. So now we have 4 unpaired electrons, but one of the electron is involved in the formation of sigma bond with the substituent, and now we have 3 unpaired electrons which are now available for bonding with metal with d orbitals of transition metal. Now since there are 3 unpaired electrons, the total spin will be 3/2 and multiplicity 2s plus 1, this will come out to be 4. Means it is quartet type carbon. Still the hybridization of carbon atom will be sp, because we have one sigma bond will be formed with metal, and in addition 2 pi bonds will be formed. So since only sigma bonds are involved, are considered for hybridization, in this case also the hybridization is sp. As far as the orbital picture is concerned, this is the case. Now you can see here, this is the sigma bond which is formed with the alkyl substituent, and now 3 orbitals of carbon atom have one unpaired electron present in each of the orbital. So since there is presence of 3 unpaired electrons, it is a quartet type carbine. So this is the basic introduction about carbines. Now how these carbines are forming bond with metal. So now we will discuss the bonding behavior. The free carbine can be considered as a doublet for Fischer and quartet for Schrock carbines. In other words, the doublet carbine forms Fischer type metal carbine complexes, whereas quartet type of carbine is involved in the formation of Schrock forms of the metal carbine complexes. Now you can see here, this is the doublet carbine and its structure is elaborated in the last portion. We have just elaborated its structure now. Doublet carbine consists of a lone pair of electron. Now this lone pair of electron is involved in the formation of metal carbon sigma bond. This is the vacant d orbital of metal. One of the metal d orbital containing unpaired electron forms pi bond with this unpaired electron present in this orbital. And one of the failed d orbital डी ऑर्बिटल ऑफ मेटल कैन ओवरलैप विद वेकेंट पी ऑर्बिटल ऑफ कार्बन टू फॉर्म एनदर पाई बॉन्ड. मीन्स सिग्मा बॉन्ड इज फॉर्म्ड फ्रॉम कार्बन टू मेटल, वन पाई बॉन्ड इज फॉर्म्ड बाई शेयरिंग ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन, एंड अदर पाई बॉन्ड इज फॉर्म्ड बाई ट्रांसफर ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन फ्रॉम मेटल टू कार्बन. सो दिस इज द बॉन्डिंग बिहेवियर इन केस ऑफ डबलेट कार्बाइन्स. सो सिंस वी हैव नाउ वन सिग्मा बॉन्ड एंड नाउ टू पाई बॉन्ड्स, इन टोटल वी हैव थ्री बॉन्ड्स बिटवीन मेटल एंड कार्बन. सो सच कंपाउंड्स आर कॉल्ड कार्बाइन कम्प्लेक्सेज, एंड पर्टिकुलरली दीज आर कॉल्ड फिशर कार्बाइन्स इफ वी हैव बॉन्डेड दिस डबलेट कार्बिन विद दैट ऑफ मेटल. सो अगेन रिपीटिंग, मेटल कार्बन सिग्मा बॉन्ड इज फॉर्म्ड बाई शेयरिंग ऑफ हाइएस्ट ऑक्यूपाइड मॉलिक्यूलर ऑर्बिटल ऑफ कार्बन विद वेकेंट डी ऑर्बिटल्स ऑफ मेटल. वन पाई बॉन्ड इज फॉर्म्ड बाई शेयरिंग ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन्स, मीन्स बाई ओवरलैपिंग ऑफ डी ऑर्बिटल विच इज हाफ फील्ड, एंड वन पी ऑर्बिटल ऑफ कार्बन एटम विच इज ऑल्सो हाफ फील्ड, मीन्स दीज टू ऑर्बिटल्स. एंड पाई बॉन्ड, सेकेंड पाई बॉन्ड इज फॉर्म्ड बाई ओवरलैपिंग ऑफ फील्ड डी ऑर्बिटल ऑफ मेटल विद वेकेंट टू पी ऑर्बिटल ऑफ कार्बन एटम. सो दिस इज द बॉन्डिंग टाइप बिहेवियर इन केस ऑफ फिशर टाइप मेटल कार्बाइन कम्प्लेक्सेज. इन केस ऑफ क्वाड्रेट कार्बाइन इट कैन बी कंसिडर्ड एज द फॉर्मेशन ऑफ मेटल कार्बन बॉन्ड एज शेयरिंग ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन्स, थ्री इलेक्ट्रॉन्स फ्रॉम मेटल एंड थ्री अनपेड इलेक्ट्रॉन्स फ्रॉम कार्बन. सो वन विल रिजल्ट इन द फॉर्मेशन ऑफ सिग्मा एंड द अदर ओवरलैपिंग्स विल रिजल्ट इन द फॉर्मेशन ऑफ पाई बॉन्ड. देयर इज वन मोर थ्योरी विच सेज दैट मेटल इनिशियली ट्रांसफर्स इट्स इलेक्ट्रॉन्स टू थ्री इलेक्ट्रॉन्स. मेटल लूजेज थ्री इलेक्ट्रॉन्स टू सी आर टू फॉर्म सी आर थ्री नेगेटिव. सो इन दिस वे वी हैव ऑल द फील्ड पी ऑर्बिटल्स फॉर कार्बन विच ओवरलैप विद वेकेंट डी ऑर्बिटल्स ऑफ मेटल टू फॉर्म थ्री मेटल कार्बन बॉन्ड्स. सो दिस इज द बॉन्डिंग बिहेवियर इन केस ऑफ श्रॉक कार्बिन्स. सो सम मोर इलेबोरेशन फॉर फिशर कार्बाइन कम्प्लेक्सेस. इन केस ऑफ फिशर कार्बाइन कम्प्लेक्सेस अ डबलेट कार्बिन इज अ टू इलेक्ट्रॉन डोनर बाया इट्स एस पी लोन पेयर ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन्स. मीन्स दिस लोन पेयर ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन इज लाइंग इन एस पी हाइब्रिडाइज्ड ऑर्बिटल. सो देर विल बी फॉर्मेशन ऑफ टू एस पी हाइब्रिड ऑर्बिटल्स, वन इज ओवरलैपिंग विद वेकेंट डी ऑर्बिटल ऑफ मेटल एंड अदर इज फॉर्मिंग सिग्मा बॉन्ड विद अल्काइल सब्सिट्यूएंट. ओके, एंड टू एडिशनल कोवलेंट बॉन्ड्स विच आर ऑफ पाई नेचर. एज वी टोल्ड यू अर्लियर दिस बॉन्ड इज फॉर्म्ड बाई शेयरिंग ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन, एंड वन मोर पाई बॉन्ड इज फॉर्म्ड बाई शेयरिंग ऑफ फील्ड डी ऑर्बिटल्स. दिस इज फील्ड डी ऑर्बिटल ऑफ मेटल विद वेकेंट टू पी ऑर्बिटल ऑफ कार्बन विच इज एक्चुअली अनहाइब्रिडाइज्ड. सो द वन पी ऑर्बिटल ऑफ मेटल रिमेन्स एम्प्टी, एंड दिस इज दैट एम्प्टी पी ऑर्बिटल विच इज अनहाइब्रिडाइज्ड एक्चुअली एंड रिसीव्स द बैक डोनेशन फ्रॉम मेटल d pi orbitals which are filled. And as far as the electron count is concerned, as we know that we generally consider covalent method, covalent model for calculating electrons, this carbine means Fischer type carbine is a three electron donor. Two electrons are donated by this sp hybrid orbital forming sigma bond with metal, and one by sharing अनपेड इलेक्ट्रॉन प्रेजेंट इन वन ऑफ द टू पी ऑर्बिटल विच इज ऑल्सो अनहाइब्रिडाइज. वो दीज ऑर्बिटल्स दे आर अनहाइब्रिडाइज. सो इन कोवलेंट मॉडल इट इज अ थ्री इलेक्ट्रॉन डोनर, वेयर एज इन केस ऑफ आयनिक मॉडल वी कंसिडर इट एज अ फोर इलेक्ट्रॉन डोनर. इन केस ऑफ श्रॉक टाई कार्बाइन कार्बाइन कम्प्लेक्सेस ए क्वाड्रेट कार्बीन, सॉरी हेयर इट शुड बी कार्बाइन. A quartet carbine can form three covalent bonds to a metal having three unpaired electrons. As I told you earlier, three unpaired electrons present in different d orbitals of metal can overlap with p orbitals of carbon each containing unpaired electron to form one sigma and two pi bond. So in this case, it is also acting as a three electron donor in covalent model. But in case of ionic model, this will be a six electron donor species, because in case of ionic model, as I told you earlier, metal will lose three electron, will increase its oxidation state by three units, and Cr will be now three negative. So each orbital of carbon is now fully filled, and these orbitals now can form bonds with vacant d orbitals of metal in this way. So one of the bond is sigma and the other two bonds are pi. So it is actually a six electron donor in case of ionic model for counting the electrons. So few more points. An electron rich hetero atom substance means which we are writing as R. This is the R. This substance can stabilize the carbene complexes. Let me write one of the example. This is a substance. This is the ligand attached to the metal tungsten, and this is triple bond carbon, and here we have other ligands attached to this tungsten, and we have Nr2 as pi donor substituent. So this pi donor substituent can stabilize this complex through conjugation. So this is W, these are other substituents, double bond C, now negative charge on metal, double bond N, R2 positive charge on this one. So this resonance stabilizes the metal carbene complexes if we have some hetero atom substituents which are actually pi donor in nature. One more important point is that instead of a triple bond to one metal, these alkynes can also form three single bonds to three metals, thereby becoming a triplet bridging mu 3 alkylidine building blocks in transition metal complexes. Means this triple bond can form a new three type complex with three different metal atoms. Okay, so there are three bonds. One is forming bond with one metal atom, second with the second metal atom, third with third metal atom. So this is also one of the possibility in which we can say that this triple bond present between carbon-carbon atom may not be bonded to only one metal atom, but may bond to three different metal atoms through sigma bonding, resulting in the formation of mu 3 alkylidine building blocks in case of transition metal complexes. So this was the basic introduction, structural behavior in case of doublet and quartet carbines with metal. So doublet carbines are considered as Fischer type carbines, whereas quartet type carbines, they are considered to form Schrock type metal carbine or metal alkylidine complexes. Okay, thank you.